Hi friends, welcome to my channel Code2Test. So we do also have a web application code2test.com where you'll come up with different tutorials on automation testing tools like Cerulean, Appium and many more. So coming for today's topic, today we are going to learn drag and drop operation in native application with Appium. So with Appium, so over here I have created a class drag and drop. So inside a class, if you click over here, we have added few of the capabilities that is being used to integrate with Appium. So these capabilities I have discussed in my previous tutorial and also in my website. If you'll go over there, you'll see multiple topics regarding these capabilities. You will go over here and click and get the capabilities. So coming over here, to understand drag and drop application, we will consider a scenario. So to consider that scenario, we have a web native application. So inside a native application, there are few functionalities that we are going to take. So taking my control towards my mobile, what I do is native application, I have installed drag and drop over here. You can take this application from Play Store and multiple of application with these things, these performance. So click to this drag and drop application and we'll come up with different multiple options. So over to it, what we'll do is we'll click to literature, this one, and after that I'll come to different we are getting a question and three answers. What we will do over here is we'll pick up the first answer, this one, and drop it over this square one in this way. So this is a drag and drop feature. We'll pick any of your answer and keep it over here. So I'll be selecting first answer. So once it being dropped, so it'll give you the confirmation that it's been dropped. So let's automate this scenario. Coming towards the coding part now. So first my scenario is one. I'll launch this drag and drop application and try to click to literature tab. This is my scenario's first step. So for this, open the Appium server, click the server and click over it, inspect session. So while clicking to it, you will get a window. Just hold on, it'll take a few minutes. Click, I have saved my settings over here. So you can also keep your settings and get saved so that you don't have to, you know, define your capabilities multiple times. Click to start button. So as you click to start, it'll take few seconds to get it open. It's a bit time taking. So let's keep on rotating. Oh, it got an error. Let's start again. It's opening. So this window in such a way will come to you, and inside this window, the window that is open to your mobile phone, it will take the screenshot over to this inspector and display like this. And now I want the XPath or the inspect element, this literature one. Just click into over it and you will get all the attributes and its values on the right hand side. So let's check the unique elements. ID is unique. Yeah, multiple. We have come up with multiple attributes. Just take the text one. I guess this is a unique one. Let's copy this one. So what we generally do is we'll take the driver instance. The system got this one. Okay, I'll find elements. I'll take mobile. By, because I am working in Android, so I'll take mobile by dot Android UI automator. Inside it, I'll take the element using UI selector. UI selector. Okay. After that, what I will do is I'll take text. Okay, I'm taking my locator on the basis of text. So I'll paste it over here. Just put it forward slash because it won't take two colons. Two semicolons cannot be taken. So take this one inside a variable, that is Android. This is an Android element, so take Android element. I'm writing a reference variable name as literature. After that, what I have to do is I have to click this element, this literature, I have to click it. So just take the reference variable and type click. What's next? What the next step is, after clicking into it, I have to take inspect this element and drag it over here. What dot? We cannot directly inspect this element and take it over here. We have to take the x and y coordinates. So what I need is I want this x and y coordinates of this mid element, mid one. This element's mid x and y coordinates. To get this x and y coordinates of mid element, firstly we have to take the x and y coordinates from this side. X, we need the location of this element till here. After that, what I need is I want y element. This one, this side, this x and y, and not directly we can take exponent. We take the location along with the size, half the size of this element. Suppose the size is 10, we have to need 5 somewhere here, and we'll add to this location part. Location of your x coordinates along with the half the size of your element. So this point I will get it. Okay. So first step is to take the x path of a. So refresh it. I came up to second window. So this is a window. Just take the x path of this element. ID is unique. So move to the ID. I need one more braces over here. Okay, copy this element, paste it over here. I'll take now on the basis of ID. On Android, we use resource ID. Resource ID. Okay, just copy this resource ID inside it. Okay, copied now. So this is my drag element. Okay, so copy this one. So once we take this element, what we discuss is we need to take the x and y coordinate. First go to x coordinate, take this element dot get the location of this element. Okay, location of x. After that, what I recalled is take the location of x element along with the half the size of this element. So I'll get somewhere over here. Okay, I'll get this half the size of my this element dot get size. Dot width. X coordinates, I'll take the width divided by 2. So this is by doing this, I'll get the element somewhere over here. X, the size of a location along with the location and the size. Just hold on. This is my location of the x element and this is my size over here. So I'll get somewhere over this one. Keep it inside this bracket. Else it will show an error. Name this element as, it will return an integer. Take the name as middle x coordinate underscore. It's a drag element. Okay, we took the x coordinates of my drag element. Now I'll take the y coordinates. The y coordinate, as I discussed with you, I'll take the location of y coordinates. This one is location till here and half the size of my y. So it will come over here. Y would be somewhere here. So I got my x elements and I'll get my y coordinates. So this would be my x and y coordinates. So just copy this one. Okay. So over here, my x would be my y and my width would be my height. Okay. So this is my y coordinate of my drag element. After that, what I will do is I will take the x path of this element, this one, where I have to perform a drag operation. So take the x path over here. So this is my unique ID. Copy it. Okay. So put it somewhere else over here. Copy this one. It is again a resource ID. Just copy this one over here and paste it like this one. So this is my answer square. So this is the answer term where we have to drop the element. Okay. So name it as drop element. Again, the same process we will follow. We will also find the x and y coordinate of this answer square. So somewhere here, over here. So just copy this drop element and dot get location dot x. Add take this one, get the size dot width divided by 2. So what generally will it do is it will take the x coordinate of this one, it will take the size of this one, location of this x coordinate over here. This is my location. This is the location. Sorry, this is the x location and half the size of your element. This is this one. So I'll add this one, this element, this position and this position. So this is would be my complete x coordinate till here. So this is what we are required. After that, name the element. It's an Android element, so it's a middle x coordinate underscore drop element. Okay, so why it's showing an error? Let me check drop element dot get location, drop element dot get size width divided by 2. Middle drop integer. Okay, sorry, it's written. It's written type is an it's an integer. Sorry. So again, in the same way, I'll find the white element. Just need to change x to y coordinate, and width would be your height. So this is your height. So you got y is somewhere like this. You get the location of this one element over here, and half the size of your drop element over this one. Half is this one, so I'll get location plus half the size. It will something like over here y coordinates. So I got my x and y coordinates. Okay, now it's a duplicate element, send it to y. After that, there's a class in IPM client Java. There is something touch action, touch, touch action. So over to it, what we generally do is inside this one, I have to pass the driver instance. Create the object of it. After that, taking the reference variable as a, and this would be something like that. Okay. So just take the instance variable of action class. Take the reference variable action dot. So what we have to do now is you take a long press to this element and drop it over here. So long press is something, a method inside this reference variable. You will type long, you will get the long press over here. So if you want to know more about long press, so you can go to the website and see inside Code2Desk, you have long press somewhere over here, tap and long press. You will come across with long press, how it works. So just over here, click to point option, This is a method. Point option dot. We have something that is point. Okay, there you need to pass it x and y coordinates of drag element. So just copy this one, drag x and y coordinates, copy this one and drop drag element y coordinate, put it over here. Okay, after that what I want to do is I want to weight my element. So we have weight action with us. Inside it we'll type weight option dot. Again we have weight option, and the duration. For the duration we have duration dot, define the time in seconds. I'll make it as 2 seconds. After that what I will do is I'll take my element this one and long press and move to this one over here. So again we have to define the point option dot option. And define the drag x and y coordinate, which is this one. We took out my x and y coordinates, copy this one and paste it over here. And what the final method we are calling is dot release and perform. This is very important thing, so don't miss it out, else it won't work. So this is something like this. So after my click, just give the weight fed off sleep for 3 seconds. After click to literature, make it 3. Okay, let's run the code now, see it's working or not. Just hold on, let's close my this application first and close the server and run again. Now let's run the code. So let's run the code and see how it works. Sorry, I think it's not got hit. Let's do it again. Okay, so let's see what happens. So it's doing something. It's happened something in my device now. Oh, it got failed. It's somewhat a connectivity issue, I guess. Yeah, it's not have created the session. Let's run again. It happens in mobiles. Hope it will work this time. So it happened. The script is taking a bit time. So we see that this native application has been invoked. After that, it had clicked the element of literature. And now we'll take the hover and place it into answer square. Yeah, it has done now. So you can see that it correct answer has been, we got a validation of correct and it did its work. Drag and drop is working fine. So you said this is the way to perform drag and drop operations. So this is quite easy. This is not something very tough. So it's very easy. You just take the element and just get its coordinates, x and y mid coordinates. This is drag drag element x and y coordinates, and these are drop x and y coordinates. And perform touch, call the object of touch action, provide the driver. Provide your x and y coordinates of drag element, weight your element and move to your destination. So, and after that click to call this release and perform action. This is how you will perform your operations. So thanks for watching my video. And if you like my video, then you can subscribe my channel and click to bell icon. Thank you. Thanks.